Casita trailers have a cult following, and it's for good reason. There are many advantages and some disadvantages to owning a Casita trailer. Casita has several designs that make very good use of space. If you consider the Liberty, it's one of the most flexible as far as sleeping arrangements. You can have a king-size bed, you can have a full-size bed, you can have two twins, and there are a lot of models of Casitas that are very flexible that will meet your needs. The Independence can accommodate either one king bed or you can have the two twin beds that like we have in here. There are 5 different models. If you have children, you can even get a Casita. It won't have a bathroom, but it will have 2 sets of bunk beds. So if you have 4 children, you can fit 6 people in there. And I think that there are some really good options with Casita. Do you want a separate dinette? You can get a separate dinette. Do you want a dinette that turns into a spare bed? You can get that too. Casita has a lot of different options. Compared to similarly sized fiberglass trailers, Casita has larger holding tanks. Casitas can be pulled with a midsize SUV or truck. Casita has a larger refrigerator than most of the similarly sized small trailers like Scamp. The appliances use limited power, of course, except the AC, and you can run most things off of solar, either a roof solar or a suitcase solar, and of course you would have to have a battery to store that solar energy. So one thing that we really like about the Casita is that it's very maneuverable off the beaten path, and we have taken it to some pretty challenging trails, maybe places that we shouldn't have, but it has done really well. We did lose a few rivets that Doug had to replace on Escalante Grand Staircase, but it was, in my opinion, it was totally worth it. So we have the high lift axle, and so the high lift axle is available on all Casitas if you order them new, and that gives you the clearance for rocks and uphill and that kind of thing. And once you get there, you have the resources to stay because you have those larger holding tanks. And if you have solar like we do and a decent battery, then that gives you even more time to stay off the beaten path. And we love that. If you'd like to see the equipment that we use when we're dry camping, check out the link in the description. So Casita and most fiberglass trailers are very aerodynamic. So the shape of your trailer has a really big impact on how it travels down the road. So fiberglass is easier to shape even than aluminum because they make a mold, and that mold makes that aerodynamic shape that helps the Casita move on down the road really well, and it gives you less resistance, and of course it gives you more fuel economy, and the shape makes it lighter and noise resistant and gives you more stability on the road. One of the things that we really love about our Casita, and I think that you would really like too, is that it's super low maintenance. So if you get a traditional stick-built trailer, then you're going to be resealing the roof at least once a year. But you're not resealing the roof on the Casita once a year. I'm telling you, your maintenance is going to be just cleaning and waxing once or twice a year helps keep these trailers looking brand new. Stick-built trailers start looking worn after a few years, where Casita will look brand new for years to come. In fact, I did a video of a 20-year-old Casita, a 2003, well, almost 20-year-old, 2003 Casita, and the owners took really good care of it, and that Casita, that thing looked brand new. You couldn't even tell it was a 20-year-old trailer. One thing about fiberglass trailers in general, and the Casita is no exception, is that you have access to your electrical system, you have access to your plumbing system. You're not cutting through a wall to get in to your systems. They're very accessible. You can access them like in the closet for the Casita, under the bed, through hatches. So you don't have to completely tear up your trailer to access those systems. I really like that. I say that like I'm the one that works on it. Doug really likes that. Casitas are very water resistant because they don't have any areas on the roof to leak. They're aerodynamic, so the roof isn't flat. And then also there's not a lot of entry points where water can get in to begin with. So that's really a plus. Plus if water does get into your Casita, then you just mop it up. If you have a laminate floor, if you have carpet and the water sits on it, it might ruin that. But underneath the Casita is fiberglass, and water is not going to ruin that. Casitas can fit into most campsites. For example, if you go to Yosemite, you're going to find that campsites at Yosemite are 35 feet long, and our Casita can fit no problem. Going to an RV park, again, you can fit in the smallest site usually in an RV park. You want to go boondocking? No problem. All those other rigs, they're trying to find a site. We found a site next to the Salmon River. Small site, we fit perfectly. And we couldn't even see our neighbors. I'm telling you, you can get into a lot of places in a casita that you can't in a larger trailer or a larger RV. Plus, purchasing a casita won't break the bank. It comes in a little under $26,000, which to some people might seem expensive, but for a fiberglass trailer, it's quite reasonable. It's actually on the low side. If you want to purchase an Oliver trailer, which are beautiful and very fancy, $57,000 just to start. You want a Bigfoot, a 17-foot Bigfoot, another beautiful trailer, $60,000. So if you make that comparison, you're gonna find, even within other small trailer markets, Scamp, very comparable, Snoozy 2, little less expensive than that. Casitas are a bargain. So with all these things said, there are some reasons that a casita just might not be for you. One of the things is that you see how much, I am 5'8". So you see that there's not a lot of room, and this is the air conditioning unit right here. So there just isn't that much room. So it's about 6'2", they say, to the top of the roof, to the top of the ceiling, and it's less right here. And the bathroom is curved, so there's sections in the bathroom that are even lower than that. And I've had a lot of people say, I'm 6'4", will I fit in the Casita Independence bed? Yes, you will, because it's 83 inches long. And the Independence is the only bed that is 83 inches long, I believe. I guess you could make the Liberty into a king and that would be longer. But you won't be able to stand up comfortably and you will have to duck. Plus the other thing that is tight is coming through the door. I can't even tell you how many times I have hit my head on that door right there. There's a rubber bumper on it, but I'm telling you, if you come in fast, you're gonna whack your head and it's gonna hurt. The other thing that I don't like about the Casita, and a lot of people have complaints about, is the finishes are really old. On the faucets, hey, the 80s called and they want their faucets back. I'm not kidding you. I mean, look at these cabinets. They are so outdated. Now, Casita does have the option of having a gray finish instead of this wood grain finish. And you can get that, or you can paint the cabinets yourself, or you can put a different kind of laminate on the cabinets if you want to. But all of the finishes, everything I think in this Casita is just, it's from the 80s. And one of the things that I really hate are these stupid blinds. They are so wrecked. And they're aluminum, and they're loud, and they make a lot of noise. You're in the trailer in the middle of the night, that blind is right next to my bed, and I hit it and it wakes me up every time, drives me crazy. Now, you can get roller shades, and I've not actually seen those roller shades in person, but I'm not that impressed. And if you get a more expensive trailer, or not even a more expensive trailer, but like, for example, if you buy an Escape, you're gonna get quality finishes, you're gonna get nice blinds, you're gonna get things that aren't outdated. Now, of course, you know, there's pluses and minuses to everything, and you know, so go back to the pluses and you'll just have to weigh things out and see how it works out for you. Another thing that people hate, like there's just some, it's like Casita, it's like you like it okay or you hate it, is the carpeted walls. People, a lot of people, they say, I just can't get over that carpeted wall. But the carpeted wall is the reason that casitas are so light. It's one of the reasons, because if you're in an, you know, a different kind of fiberglass trailers, might have two layers of fiberglass with insulation in between. In a casita, the carpeting is the insulation, and it's also sound dampening, which it does a really good job. You don't have condensation on the walls. It does dampen the sound on the wall. So people say, can I take it off? Well, no, you can't take it off, because if you take it off, well, you can take it off, but it would be so much work, it wouldn't even be worth it. If you take it off, you've got a rough fiberglass surface on the wall for one thing. You lose your sound dampening and you lose your insulation, and then you've got condensation on the walls. So if you hate the carpet, Casita is not gonna work for you. And Scamp, the same thing. Scamp also has, it's not carpet, it's a different kind of a textile insulation. The other thing that's a downside for some people is that Casitas can only be purchased through the factory. So if you want a new Casita, you're gonna have to buy it from the factory, because they don't sell through dealers. And you'll find that that's pretty common with a lot of fiberglass trailers. I know that Bigfoot is one outlier on that. You can get a Bigfoot at a dealer, but Casita trailers, you have to buy them from the Casita manufacturer. Now, they're in Texas, so you think, well, how in the world am I gonna go? I have to go to Texas to see a Casita? Well, no, you don't. So they have a plan where they'll give you the names of some people that are willing to show you their Casita. So you want a certain model, or maybe just want to see a Casita in general. And you can connect up with those people that are in your area that already have a Casita, and you can see one that way. And I tell you, there's a lot to be said for actually going into an RV and checking it out and making sure that, like, for example, the height. I wouldn't have known that. The layout. It's just, I wouldn't recommend buying anything sight unseen. So that's a really good way that you can see a Casita without having to go to Rice, Texas. So then I order my Casita and I'm gonna have to go pick it up in Rice, Texas. And that's not the case. They will deliver it. Of course, you'll have to pay a delivery fee, but that's an option too. So I will tell you that the foam cushions do not meet my expectations for sleeping. They are very thin and they're very uncomfortable. They're okay maybe to sit on, but as far as sleeping on them, they're no go. So we settled on Southern Mattress, which makes mattresses for Casitas. Here's one thing people really don't like about the Casita is the heater. The heater is so loud. It sounds like a helicopter taking off. And it will wake you up in the middle of the night. We use the heater. It's really convenient. I know a lot of people get like a Mr. Buddy heater or something like that, but Casitas don't have that much room. So having a Mr. Buddy or something else in your Casita just takes up needed space. Now, on the air conditioner, if you order the air conditioner, then there is a heat strip on there, and that's a lot quieter, but you have to be plugged in to use that. For our Casita, it's a really tight fit in here, so if I want to get dressed, then Doug has to go out, or vice versa. So I can't get dressed while he's getting dressed, I can't make breakfast while he's getting dressed, and I think that's true for most Casitas. I haven't obviously lived in another Casita, but having been in other Casitas, they are a really tight fit, and so that's something that you need to know, that you're going to be shuffling around each other, moving around each other if there is more than one of you. And if you have kids, then it's going to be even more exciting. A lot of people just make an outdoor kitchen and make an outdoor living space. You know what? You're camping anyway, so why not? And that's how they deal with it. We just shuffle around each other, and that's what we do. The one thing that is really annoying, super annoying about the Casita is that there is no exterior storage space to speak of. There is some under the bed space, but it's really hard to access because the compartments are tiny. And getting into stuff, I mean, you're like trying to get in there with your arms and get around stuff, and it's just kind of a pain in the neck. So Casita, make larger hatches. That's what I say. The other thing is the battery compartment. You want to have two batteries? Forget it. Only one battery will fit in that battery compartment. So we got a lithium battery, and so we have one lithium battery in that compartment. Now, if you're working with lithium batteries, you can put lithium batteries under the bed and they will fit under there. You know, you can rewire it and everything. You cannot have lead acid batteries inside of your living space. So that battery compartment, the reason why you can't even expand it is because it's a fiberglass, enclosed fiberglass shell, because it comes with the lead acid battery. If you'd like to see a video of our Casita trailer where I show you the whole trailer, check out this video. If you'd like to see a video of Mike and Cindy's Liberty Deluxe trailer, that's the one that I told you was like the really flexible sleeping arrangements, check out this video. If you'd like to see more videos like this one, hit the subscribe button.